Hello and welcome to That So Science Takes on Vita. What is Vita? Vlog every day in August. Doing Vita to get more practice, which means more videos, more editing, and definitely more science coming your way. So I missed a couple days, so let me just start off with introductions. I'm Julia Wild and I am a science blogger. I just graduated from college in May. I have a degree in English literature, but my two minors are art and biology. This might seem like an odd combination, but I really like learning about stuff. August 2nd was Social Stereotype by Social Stereotype. I'm pretty much a geek, or a nerd, or a dork, whatever you want to call it. I just love stuff. I love learning, and I can't stop learning. It's kind of my favorite thing in the universe, or the multiverse, whichever you choose. I do have a bit of hippie in me. My family used to say I was a flower child growing up. Peace and love, man. I am definitely a nerdfighter, DFTBA. That's kind of how I got into Vita. One of my nerdfighter friends introduced me to it. I find stereotypes very useful. I think as long as you're willing to think outside stereotypes, but they're a good way to kind of navigate the world and figure out kind of where a person is coming from or kind of what you like to be. Like, nerd is a very useful stereotype. It just means you enthusiastically love stuff, and that's totally cool. So if I see somebody who calls themselves a nerd, I'm like, you, you're like me. Let's be friends! What I want to do with my life is write about science. With my degree in English literature, I would like to make stories about science compelling. And the way that I would like to do that is to have them very human interest based. I believe these human interest elements make these stories a lot more memorable. For instance, most people don't remember the formula for gravity, but most people remember the story of Isaac Newton and the apple falling from the tree. So space is really compelling on its own, but how many millions of views did Chris Hadfield get? So there's an example of a human really driving an interesting story about science. I believe that these human interest elements in storytelling really helps you remember the science more than simply memorizing a list of facts. Well, today, especially, is Esther Day, which in Nerdfighteria is named after a girl named Esther who died a couple years ago of cancer. And all she wanted to remember her is on her birthday every year, we tell somebody that we love them. And this isn't romantic love, it's kind of Valentine's Day for the rest of love. So this is about friends, family, telling people you love them, the kind of people you normally don't say it to on an everyday basis. Make sure you go out there and tell them you love them. I love you. Mwah! So let me know what kind of topics you guys want to hear about. Thus far, I've talked about superbugs, I've talked about going to the gynecologist. Coming up, I think I would like to do topics on beer, the science of beer, the science of coffee, and why it's so addicting. I would like to do some ecology videos. I want to do one on barrier islands and why it's a problem we build on them. So if any of these sound appealing, or if you have a different idea, please comment in my pants. That would be super duper. And I will talk to you soon. Vita, 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 Vita. Vlog every day in August.